McDonald's suffers a global tech outage that disrupted its restaurant operations. Dozens of McDonald's stores in Japan and Australia stopped taking orders Friday due to the system disruption. Customers in Hong Kong, New Zealand, China, Sweden, and the UK also reported glitches in their local Mickey D's. They said they were unable to place orders in stores and online. The fast food giant has ruled out a cybersecurity incident for that outage and said the issue is now being resolved. A World Bank report bears the Philippines still has slower and pricier internet than its Southeast Asian peers. Among the reasons, outdated policy frameworks and weak competition. Jackie Pasquale with the full story.
The Philippines still lags behind other Southeast Asian neighbors in terms of internet connectivity. This was the key finding of the World Bank's Better Internet for All Filipinos report, which says the country has, on average, slower fixed broadband speed compared to Singapore, Thailand, Malaysia, Vietnam, and Brunei. The cost in the Philippines, however, is higher than most in the region at 11.3% of the gross national income per capita. Data on mobile broadband also have similar rankings. The government agrees with the findings.
This is a sobering reminder of the pressing need to further efforts to bridge the digital gap in many parts of our country. We have to work doubly hard.
We're improving, but you know, our neighbors are also improving, so we have to catch up.
The report states that the country's geography is not the issue, but because of outdated policy frameworks, weak competition, tedious licensing process, and more. They are pushing for amending the Radio Control Act of 1931, which governs spectrum management, as well as the Open Access in Data Transmission Bill, which will help expand internet infrastructure.
It would mean internet would be more accessible to ordinary people, for inclusivity. It will mean that our children can now access better educational services, improve the quality of the internet services, so higher speed, so that we can do video streaming and all that, those that require stability and speed. Two, it will make it less affordable.
Improve regulatory efficiency in telecommunications. Include the formulation of an improved national broadband plan and even the Philippine Communication Satellite Framework.
The U.S. Agency for International Development, which is also helping improve connectivity in the country, says better internet can lead to economic growth and reforms must be done now.
Our progress will be limited without transformative legislation that will ensure digital development is sustained and the Philippine ICT sector is competitive.
Government vows to beef up internet connectivity in the country, with DICT saying it will expand its free Wi-Fi program to more remote areas this year. NEDA, meanwhile, says they welcome more private or foreign investments in the telco sector. Jackie Pasquale, ABS-CBN News.
The Philippine Ombudsman lifts the preventive suspension on 23 warehouse employees of the National Food Authority. This is after the employees cooperated with a probe into the controversial sale of rice buffer stocks last year. Ombudsman Samuel Martirez says employees may now return to work and receive proper compensation. The lifting of their preventive suspension comes a day after 108 suspended NFA employees filed motions for reconsideration before the ombudsman. Martirez says the suspension orders of other workers may be lifted if they cooperate.
We're not saying that any of these respondents that were preventively suspended are guilty. We're not also saying that they are not guilty. Wala pa kaming masyadong ebidensya. The evidence of guilt may not be strong, but we have to protect the documents. Diba? We have to protect also the witnesses, possible witnesses, from being harassed by the respondents.